thanks for coming. Champions for the Minnesota game on offense was Jeff Hyreman and Nick Vinette. Both played very well. I think Nick Vinette's earned some more playing time, so we're going to try to get him more involved. He's practicing very well. Offensive line was Darryl Baldwin. Quarterback, JT, great out of Champion. And running back, Zeke Elliott did. And player of the game was Evan Spencer on offense. Just does a lot of things for us. On defense, players, champions were Josh Perry, Mike Bennett, Eli Apple, and he's playing his best football since he's been here. And Duran Grant's very consistent. Guy that I'm going to nominate for all Big Ten, he's playing very well for us. Player of the game, we had two of them, co-players of the game, Von Bell and Joey Bosa. And special teams player of the week was Jeff Hyreman, who recovered an onside kick and kind of saved our bacon on one of the punts that they gave us an unusual look. So, big game. Not sure what that was. I'm not sure I want to know what that was. Make sure mine's off here. I can assure you mine doesn't sound like that. Great to come back home. Two road games against top 25 opponents. Two teams that we have a lot of respect for that we played, and it was every bit that we thought it would be. And there's a good chance we'll get Briante done back, and so we're getting a little bit healthy. Dontre, obviously, we missed him last week. Jalen had a tough game, but we haven't lost confidence. Jalen, we don't do that here. If you don't play hard, that's a whole different animal. But he'd play hard, make mistakes. You just got to fix it, and he's going to, you know, work on a lot of things this week to get himself better. So I'll answer your questions for you.
Front row, Todd.
Urban, we've asked you, I think, a couple weeks now about JT and whether or not you think he's a Heisman candidate. But when you look at what he's done and look at his numbers, at what point do you sort of endorse him as a Heisman?
I did. I don't know if my endorsement matters, but I do statistically. Been fortunate to coach some guys that have been in New York. And he's a Heisman candidate.
The other question I wanted to ask you was, at this point in the season, you guys are a win away from clinching a spot, you know, back in Indianapolis. Are you having as much fun now as you did when you were younger coaching?
I'm having a lot of fun coaching this team because they yesterday was a perfect example. They went out and they worked their tails off, you know, and, you know, JT's a Heisman candidate that knows that he could have played much better Saturday. And that's the best thing about coaching these guys right now. I hope it doesn't change. You know, that's something we're watching very closely with. You know, guys are starting to get some notoriety. You know, Zeke has a chance to get 1,000 yards. And the minute he becomes something other than Zeke Elliott, that's a problem. And same with JT, same with Joey Bosa. Some of these players are, you know, Mike Thomas. Mike Thomas didn't play particularly well. And so I watched him very closely yesterday. And it was nothing other than go out and I didn't play very well. I got to play better. And that's what every coach wants to be around. And this team is like, I just got to make sure they don't change.
Second row left, Rob. Urban. Those were tough conditions Saturday.
And I'm sorry?
Those were tough conditions, obviously. I know you said something about you'd like to see other teams come in and do that. First question is, when you were at Florida, how tough would it have been to go to a place like that? Would it have been extra tough because of what you were used to?
I think any time if you ask a team from Ohio or you know, a northern team to go down to a southern school in the summer, I mean, it's ridiculous. We did that when I was there. I remember Wyoming coming down there and some teams, and there was a 100-degree differential between I remember doing that stat. When Wyoming played their last game, it was 100 degrees different than they played their first game the next year. And that can only happen a few places. Wyoming and Florida. So, yeah, it would be ridiculous to try to get a group of players from no different than a group of players from up here to go down and play in 110 heat index. It's not impossible, but it's difficult.
Second part of that is when the playoff goes eight teams, probably not if, would you be in favor of home sites? I mean, the first round home sites coming up.
We play Indiana, man. I'm not sure how that works.
I know that there were points last year where you were saying that you wish Braxton wasn't running as much because you didn't want to expose him to that much risk. Are you pleased in that standpoint with JT Barrett?
Yeah, a lot of his are scrambles. You know, the one that he came out the other end, the 90-yard run, was a called run, or whatever it was, 80-some-yard run, it was a called run. We're going to, you know, it's just such a good thing to have. You know, it's kind of your crutch. We got to get off that a little bit. A lot of JT's yards, he's a very good scrambler. The thing that JT does so well, and that's why we stay on course a lot of time, is if it's not there, he puts his foot in the ground and gets 6 yards. And that puts us in second and four instead of hanging around back there. That's a great quality of his right now. And we don't want that to change. So I don't mind that because he's pretty good at getting down. But we got to limit the quarterback run calls. But we have. We're not near like we were a few years ago.
Speaking of good runners, Tevin Coleman, what is it that makes him successful for him?
I've not studied him. I see his statistics are ridiculous. I met with our defensive staff again this morning, last night and this morning, and they think he's an outstanding, great back. Not real big, but fast, extremely fast. I have not studied him. That's usually Wednesday I do that. But I know our guys are, that's the threat, number one threat on their team.
Tackling was a big issue for your defense last year. It seems much better this
year. Much better.
I know there was still one where they were trying to pull the ball out and Cobb went in for a touchdown. But overall, can you just talk about the tackling this year?
We're not a big strip. You won't see that. You know, I better not see that. It's not. We don't. If you're wrapped up, you can go in there and get the ball. But that was really bad 2 years ago. And Coach Fickle and Coach Ash are the primary guys that teach that, along with Coach Combs, obviously. I can't imagine a team works harder on tackling than we do. We work that every week, and that's non-negotiable.
Backup D tackles, I know you talk about them a lot. Is there one guy who's close to stepping
Shutt's up? Close. He had a good week of practice, and I like Tom Shutt. Disappointed him. You know, I thought when we recruited him, he'd be a guy that'd be a role in there. And he's, you know, we're meeting every week now. He's asking what he can do better, and he had his best week of practice. So he's a good guy that comes from good people, and we want to get him on the field. He's got to play better. That's an area we're still, that's not where we need to be right now.
Front row right, awesome. Urban, as a coach, when you leave a game like Saturday, as, you know, Dontre 2 weeks ago, Jalen Saturday, do you leave more worried about the ball security or pleased and encouraged by what he does when he holds on to football?
No, very concerned about, we've fumbled more this year than we have, and we had a little conference about that. The offense coaches, myself, and our players yesterday, and I think we got lazy a little bit in practice, and that's my fault. I got to hold these guys accountable, and very disappointed when that ball's on the ground. You're not going to win a close game by doing that.
You referenced these last couple weeks, too, this philosophy that guys can't be afraid to make mistakes. Did you think the last 2 years, or last year, at any point that you had a team that was afraid to make a mistake?
I don't think so. I just don't want to, you know, I'll hear people say, you know, if he fumbles, he won't play again for another 6 games, you know. And I don't, if I see a fundamental flaw in how he's holding the ball, then he won't play for 6 games. But fumbles, like if a guy jumps offside, you know, that's part of, I want a real aggressive team that's not worried about making mistakes. And I think we have that. But they're also, it's a fundamental when you start seeing low, you know, I'm seeing our receivers not very tight with the ball right now. And JT Barrett, Ezekiel Elliott are very tight. You watch them all the time. We call it chin, chin, chin. They're real tight with it. So we just got to, it's a fundamental issue right now, not an effort issue.
Tim.
Yeah. Robert, following up on that, though, other than the drops, have you been pleased with what Jalen has brought to the table from
yes.
the standpoint? I mean, he's always cutting up field looking for that play.
He's real aggressive on punt returns. You know, that's something that, I'm getting ready to make a change of punt returner, and then Zach Smith and I had a long conversation. We went and watched every one of his punt returns. He's very aggressive to the ball. You know, they don't drop very often on him. He'll go get it, and we don't want to lose that, you know. So we just got to make sure, we're taking care of business, get him the reps.
And the other thing, you mentioned Eli Apple a while ago. Can you talk about his rise just in the last 4 or 5 games? I mean, obviously he gave y'all a spark when he came off the bench in Michigan State and a few four or five games ago. I'm not sure anybody
wasn't full speed either.
Yeah.
Eli Apple is a guy that I'd like to think is a product of the way we do our business. He's in the weight room, in the classroom. You know, he's kind of a how can I say that? He was not what we wanted when we signed him. He was lazy in the classroom, lazy about his business. He's got a great family that really supported us in our disciplining of him, and he's doing great in school and doing great on the field. And I grabbed him yesterday and I said, "This is what we recruited," and he's playing pretty well.
Let me ask one last quickie, because Rob was asked this a while ago, but I'm just wondering, do you think I know you're talking about Indiana, but do you think the committee is going to take into consideration y'all were playing in constant snow on Saturday, it was 16 degrees, mistakes happen. And those, I mean, do you have faith in the committee to look at everything, I guess, as they judge teams nationally?
I think, you know, I see some coaches on there that probably have been in Minnesota and played, and, you know, I guess for the person that has no clue, I have no faith in them. For people that understand ball and all that, yeah. And once again, I don't really know who's on it. I'm sure they were well picked.
Bill, a little bit along those lines, you guys are kind of on two tracks here. You obviously have to win. That's all you can control. But there is this playoff. You're trying to get into the playoff. A 31-24 win over Indiana probably won't help you. How do you kind of balance the idea that you have to obviously take care of business, but there is this perception game?
That's not even going to be addressed. You know, we wake up every November, or we wake up every day to compete for championships in November. It's at the doorstep now. They've done a good job getting us there. And if you'd have told us after week two that this would all start to materialize, I think we just keep doing what we're doing, and that's get better each week. We are lights out, much better football team than we were at the beginning of the season. And that's a credit to the players and the assistant coaches for getting them there. But those kind of conversations, I think, take place in here. They certainly don't take place within locker rooms, and not that I'm aware of.
Would you be willing to say that you're one of the four best teams in the country?
Not right now, no. No, I don't, because I don't want to make ignorant comments. I just don't know. You know, I'd make the comment that we're one win away from representing the East in the Big Ten championship game, because I do know that.
Far left, Doug.
Ruben, with Zach Smith and that receiver group this year, what have you seen just in terms of, they have that zone six thing they've like nicknamed for themselves, and just like in terms of what Zach has done with that attitude in that room or the togetherness in the room? We know, you know, that room has been an issue at times in your time here. What have you seen? Obviously they're playing better. Is there something about the way they're approaching things?
I wish you would have asked me last week. I would have been more positive. They didn't play very well this week, so that zone six stuff or whatever, I'm going to blow it up. No, I'm not. I think Zach is, I told him, he coached his best game against Michigan State. High energy, very good blocking downfield, making plays downfield, you know, just, and then this past week we didn't play very good. And I, you know, the dog ate my homework excuse about the weather and all that, that's the way it is. So he has done, this has been a good year for Coach Smith and the receivers, much different approach to the game that we, when we first got here. So he's done a good job.
And I know you have, you're worried about your thing with your team for Indiana, but Florida is making a coaching change. What, for anybody who goes in there next, from what you know, having gone in there when Florida was down, what does the next coach at Florida, what do you need to do to succeed?
I'm just worried about Indiana.
But nobody knows.
Nice try, though.
Rusty. Urban, when you talked about goals and motivation, whether last January or any time up until now, for this 2014 season, returning to the Indianapolis for the Big Ten title, how big was that?
That was everything. That was everything we did, is get another shot at the Big Ten championship. So everything, and that's at the doorstep. So I imagine that's why they were pretty juiced up yesterday for practice.
And Indiana's rushing for like 265 yards a game or something like that. Could you address what your run defense must do?
Yeah, against the team? You know, we played much better than I anticipated watching the film. You know, we had some missed tackles, safety position missed a few tackles, bad ones, and we have to work on that. But I thought our defensive front, I didn't get the feel during the game. Our defense, Mike Bennett played his, one of his best games as a Buckeye. Joey Bosa was ridiculous. Steve Miller's going hard, and Adolphus didn't do bad. So. We just got to make sure we're gap sound, be very smart, and we're facing one of the best rush teams, certainly in the Big Ten, and we're just, I think we're comfortable with the style of defense we're playing to go play Indiana and stop that run or limit that run offense.
Far left, Matt.
Dovetailing off of that, you're playing Tevin Coleman, who had a 300-yard rushing game last week. You played Jeremy Langford a couple of weeks ago, this Cobb kid. Melvin Gordon's going crazy. People talk about this league. Have you run into this many backs, it seems like,
no,
week
I haven't.
After week?
I haven't, and then you see that they're doing it against some of the top rush defenses in the country. That's one thing I noticed about it. I was just looking at our conference rush defenses, and who we've faced the last few weeks, they're very good against the rush. I think the last two were top 10.
Minnesota was 21, Penn State was 5, Michigan State was 5.
So we're just very good run defenses, and then you throw these big time backs in there. So there's some NFL players in this league going to be carrying the ball.
And nationally, a lot of times people.
And I think Zeke, I got to throw my guy in there now.
Yeah.
You know, I just, for whatever reason, he doesn't have the same touches, but I like our back.
Nationally, you know, a lot of times people have talked about the Big Ten and this and that. But, you know, heading into last week, the committee had 5 in the top 25. You got out of Minnesota with a win. You're in the middle of this. How are you seeing any down Big Ten as you're going through this?
I think the upper half is, I think the one thing that I got to be smart how I say this. I think the Big Ten conference, it's no secret. The difference between that and the other top conferences is not 1 through 5. I think it's the whole thing. And I see teams getting better, to answer your question. You know, Northwestern goes in there and beats Notre Dame. And Northwestern, to me, is, you know, last year I remember there was 15th in the country or 16th in the country. So the consistency of teams in our conference, I think, is the only thing lacking at times. But that's without studying it. But the top 5 teams in our conference, you know, they can play anywhere.
You're even playing a team in Missouri. I know they've had injuries to the quarterback since then. But.
Yeah, and they beat Missouri at Missouri. And I think Missouri's in the first in the East in the SEC.
Last two. Second row left, Ari.
Coach, talk about Ezekiel Elliott a lot, but what do you see out of Curtis Samuel? I know he was really involved at one point.
Yeah.
You know, it's kind of up and down with him. He seemed to run pretty well when he was returning kickoffs.
Yeah.
What do you see about his progression?
We got to get him in the game. You know, Zeke's got the hot hand right now and playing really, really well. I mean, he's playing high level football for us, and we've had some really tough games that you want your best guy with the ball in his hand right now. So that's the only thing. He's not done anything wrong. He had a little injury that set him back for about 2-3 weeks. But he's full speed now and did a nice job on the kickoff return before the half. Got us. I was ready to just kneel on the ball and get out of there because of the conditions of the field and everything. And we knocked it out past the 40-yard line, went down and kicked a field goal because of that kick return. So he's doing great. We just got to get him more involved.
And last question over here to the right, Clay.
Coach, you addressed this a week or two ago, but every place I go, people are asking me about JT and Braxton, how that's going to work next year. You said it'd be great to have two fine quarterbacks here if that's the plan. Can you clarify, is there another plan in place, or is it just going
to
evolve?
The plan in place is to try to clinch the Big Ten championship representative of the Eastern Division. That's our plan. Thanks, guys.